Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the beautiful state of Louisiana, where the temperatures have been more like maybe North Carolina. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord, I've been down here, been trying to hear from the Lord. Everything the Lord keeps talking to me about is judgment. So I've just been praying about it and researching the things that the Lord's been showing me to give a more definitive message from the Lord. But the Lord has just been spoke to me about danger. Danger. It's been showing me something to do with through the like chickens. You know, these kind of things. I mean, I made plenty of videos about the judgment of the Lord coming to the United States. And to the world, we know that the tribulation is coming, and the Lord is just, keep showing me this thing, several Bible verses and stuff. I'm going to make a video about it, just trying to pray for confirmation about it and better understanding before I make a video. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I'll be heading out to be back in Dallas. I'll be visiting some people in Dallas after I leave Louisiana on the 21st, 20th and 21st. I'll be meeting some brothers there in Dallas area, near the Dallas-Fort Worth airport area. If you know me from YouTube, maybe we can I can still have time to see a few more people. I have some openings. I don't have any more openings right now. But maybe in Dallas on the 20th and 21st. Then I'll be out in California, near Bakersfield, California, and Las Vegas area. I'll be seeing the people who I saw last time in Las Vegas. There's one brother. I haven't contacted him since I was in Vegas. I need to try to email him and see if he wants to meet with me also. And then there's several people in Vegas who, lots of different people in Vegas I saw, and a few people in Vegas who I didn't get a chance to. I'll be there the last week of February. In the first few days of March, I'll be there for 1 week in Las Vegas, and then back to. I'll be seeing people there in around the area there of around the Bakersfield area, within an hour or two drive of that area. Just contact me, and I'll be there until the end of the first week of March. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm gonna make those videos and then the things that the Lord's been showing me, but I just wanted to ask you guys to pray. I know I mentioned this before, because the Lord has given me the message about adding two new orphanages. And then the Lord, has led me that, of course, my wife needed to get her American citizenship. Our son is a American citizen by birth through me. And so my wife has to do 3 years really in the United States to get her citizenship. I've been in the Philippines 7 years doing mission work. And now I'm going to spend at least the next 3 years, or now we got 2.5 left or so, just say 3 years in the States. Now we stay beyond that, it's up to the Lord. We'll stay here for the rest of my life, it's up to the Lord. Will I go back to the Philippines after that 3 years? It's up to the Lord. I'm open to those things. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so we're going to be building, supposed to be two more orphanages, as the Lord has led me, spoken to me about. And then we're starting this online church, the Church of the Firstborn, which the Lord is the firstborn from the dead, reference to Hebrews chapter 12, that is going to heaven, the church that will see the rapture, preparing the bride for the rapture. That's the mission of the church, as the Lord has given me the mission to prepare the bride to meet the bridegroom. That's the mission, the primary mission of the Church of the Firstborn. Now the Lord had given me the title of the church, and then just the other day he gave me the mission of the church while I was in Dallas. I don't think I mentioned that in the video I made the other day, but anyway, that's the calling, brothers and sisters. Of course, we have the Joshua's ministry, which is basically in the Philippines with the orphanages and the feeding programs that we feed 300 to 500, so say 400 kids a week, who are street kids, basically, who live in shacks. So, some of them are, both parents are dead. Some of them, one parent are dead. Some of them, their parents are alive and they don't have jobs. They're drunks and whatnot. Lots of different things. And then we have the orphans. Right now we have about 13 plus orphans. There are some new ones we're still trying to process and get them in. Should be at 20 orphans, and then by the end of maybe this month, we're still working on it. It's a process to get the orphans in the orphanage, get it all worked out. So it looks like we'll have 20 orphans, as soon as we get done processing them, and our orphanage will be maxed out. So the Lord has already talked to me about the two new orphanages. So I'm just mentioning these things. These are the things I'm asking for your prayers. I do not even know where we will live when we move here in May. If you've been watching my videos, that because of immigration, there, if we stay gone any longer than that for the rest of this 12-month period, then it's a, you know, it would, my wife's citizenship, you know, progress will be in danger of her losing her green card. So we need to come to the States and stay. You know, you need to spend the majority of the each year in the United States for the next 3 years, and particularly so many months in a row to get your citizenship. It's, you know, so we're basically going to be staying here just the next 2 years. By the grace of God, we'll go to the Philippines, say 2 months a year. That's about all we can do until we finish the citizenship processing. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray about that. I ask for your prayers and support and wisdom and consideration where we might live during this time. I have no idea. If we're doing the online church only, I can do that from anywhere where I have an internet connection, obviously. Can manage the orphanage through the internet. We have the internet now at the orphanage. Praise God, there was no signal there before. Just now, in the month of January, there was a signal, internet signal to get with an antenna there at the orphanage. So that came online in time for us to make this move where I can communicate with the house mom and dad via internet directly. And so we can, you know, I can really do it from the States. I can Skype with them. I can, you know, email them anytime. They can send photos and all that directly. And it's just so much going to be so much easier. So I believe that's really the hand of God that makes a way for me to manage the orphanage from anywhere. So brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray about all these things. And any ones of you guys who are mature in the Lord wants to message me about it, something the Lord is, you think the Lord is leading you about this situations, please message me. It's just so, I will just say this, it's something that's funny, that I had one person who is actually the child of immigrants, who is actually a multi, I say, I don't know how many times I can say multi-millionaire, who doesn't believe in tithing. That's a good idea. Of course, he doesn't believe in tithing, and he was telling me, you know, my wife should just give up her green card after all the time and effort, and of course, that's my wife. I'm an American, so of course the Lord would want her to be with me. Of course, you're supposed to cohabitate with your husband or wife. And as the Lord would send me back and forth to do the work that the Lord has me doing in the States through the YouTube ministry and the sponsors of the orphans and all that, and bring revival to the United States, all the things that the Lord called me to do, you know, God is the one who provides for us, and God is the one that will provide for you. And that's why we always have to put our trust in the Lord. We never put our trust in people. Particularly, you know, I just wanted to say this. I've been debating on whether to say this. This year, on this trip that I took to the States from August until December, I had two houses offered to me. And then later on, the people just on a whim offered the houses, obviously, and on a whim changed their mind. I had offers for orphanages, $150,000 promised, plus, $150,000 plus, offered to build orphanages that was reversed on a whim, offered on a whim and reversed on a whim. So I just thank the Lord. And, you know, I'm telling you guys this because maybe you guys, you know, experienced some things in your life and, like, but lots of you guys, you know, you get inspiration from me about walking by faith, you know, and going to the Philippines and, you know, serving the Lord and things like this. You cannot be moved by people. People will say things and do things. And, you know, as we used to say when I was in the Army, in God we trust, all others we check. You know, and that, just like on the money, you know, as God we trust, all others we check. You will find... And this is why lots of people get offended. You know, Jesus said, blessed are those who are not offended in me. If you're easily offended, you know, then, you know, that's the reason why lots of people don't go to church, because they're easily offended. They've been offended, you know. And then Jesus said it's impossible that offenses will not come. You know, we're going to be offended, you know, but Jesus has overcome the world. So we have to turn the other cheek and forgive people no matter what. And like I said, as you guys have been watching my videos, I've explained on this last time I came to the States, Because I had several people I was trying to, play with me or exploit my anointing or exploit Joshua's ministry and try to, just any kind of way. You know, you meet people that are, you know that people have all kinds of different motives that's not from God. You know, you never know. I've had people try to, to tempt me to get drunk with them. People trying to tempt me to sleep with them. This last time I was in the States, I had people, like as I mentioned, offering houses for us to live in, and then on a whim just rescinding it, on a whim offering it. Finances, on a whim offering it. A huge amount, as I mentioned, is a total of over $150,000, and then on a whim rescinding it. For no, just like it's no big deal. But by the grace of God, God is the one that provides, brothers and sisters. So I just ask you to continue, those of you who are the prayer warriors that God has given to me as my sisters and brothers in Christ. I thank the Lord for you guys. I thank the Lord that, that He will never leave me for nor forsake me. And those of you, who God has assigned to minister to me, minister me as your brother and Lord, I thank you for it. You know, there's lots of people. I've ministered to thousands of people. I've laid hands on and ministered to thousands and thousands. I don't know how many thousands of people. Hundreds of them, or maybe even thousands, have been healed. I know for sure thousands and thousands, maybe even 50,000 people have been saved, through the preaching that the Lord has let me do. And I thank the Lord for that. But, just like anybody else, I need to be ministered to also through God's people. God uses His people usually to minister to me. So I think those, if I started naming names, I don't want to name people's names who's helped me. Because, their reward is with the Lord. But there's the sister that's loaned me a vehicle when I've come to the States this both times. The sister that helped me is helping us with the website, really to design the website. There's a sister, another sister that's going to do the administration of the website, I guess moderating some of the blogs or whatever you want to call it, sister that's going to do that. There's lots of people who have helped Joshua's ministry, but not even talking about helping Joshua's ministry, but it's ministered to me. People who've messaged me with words of encouragement, prayed for me specifically. Some people have gotten words from the Lord for me, and some of them are really from the Lord. Now, there are people that will send you a message and it's way out, they're not really hearing from the Lord, but there are people that do hear from the Lord. Lots of people. And several of them have given me a word and encouragement and all that from the Lord, and I know it's from the Lord because the Lord had already told me the same thing, and then someone would message me the exact same thing the Lord had just spoken to me, as a confirmation. So I thank you guys for that. All of those who have personally ministered to me and encouraged me. From the very beginning of this YouTube channel, that's how people have known me through YouTube. I just want to thank you guys for your encouragement. And I hope that I can be more of a blessing to all the people who the Lord would have me to encourage and bless. And I guess it's through my videos. I personally message with people, dozens of people, basically every day. I spend hours answering people's emails. And no, I won't cookie cut people's answers. There's someone... He told me just to make it like a business. Just cookie cut your answers to send to people. Don't waste your time, answering people's questions. I never do that. By the grace of God, I always contemplate and pray about and think about answering people with their problems. Brothers and sisters, there's people that message me every day that just found out they got cancer. Or their husband's cheating on them. Their husband's on drugs and he ran away and he's, with another woman or whatever. I mean... You name it, I get messages every day. This is real life problems. That's why I get frustrated. I know only those who are lovers of Joshua's ministry will be watching this, because I'm not going to give it a fancy title. But like I've said this many times, it is very frustrating when I make a video about what the Lord showed me about the rapture and 2,000 people watch it. And then most of those people are just wanting to debate and argue, or, not saying most of them want to debate. Thank the Lord, only a few of them want to debate. 99%, though, they want to know when's the rapture and all that. And they're not contributing to the body of Christ. And I mean praying for people, encouraging people. They're just running to and fro. And then, There's people who are messaging me that have real life problems, and then these people that are just running around, and those are the ones I'm talking about on the shallow end of the pool, not new Christians. Someone told me that I was insulting new Christians by saying on the shallow end of the pool. No, I'm not talking about new Christians. I'm talking about people who are shallow-minded. I'm talking about people who are only thinking about themselves. They could have been a Christian for 40 years. They're only all about themselves and about they want to go in the rapture and they want to get some word from the Lord for themselves and all this. And they don't even have any problems in their life. That's what I'm saying. There are tons of people, as I said, every day I get at least one message or two messages. Somebody found out they're dying of cancer. Their mom just died. Their dad just died. And they weren't a Christian. Things like that. Their son is on drugs and then going to jail and are just, all those real life problems. Those are the things that God called me, as in the pastor part of me to deal with. And that's why I need you guys who are prayer warriors to pray for me, that I will have the wisdom and the strength and the grace from God to minister to those who got real problems, that real life and death issues. Now, I've been walking this tightrope across the Niagara Falls for the last 13 years, blindfolded, walking across a tightrope over Niagara Falls blindfolded. And by the grace of God, I never look down by God's grace. Sometimes I do, and get nervous and worried about it. Some days, everybody has a bad day. But the advice that when you're a preacher and you give someone advice, like, should I divorce my husband? He keeps beating me. Should I leave him? These are the kind of questions people ask you. That could be the matter of life and death. If you go around and say, oh, God hates divorce, it's an adult, it's a sin, it's going to be adultery if you leave that your husband or whatever. And then their husband, what if their husband ends up killing them? And you told them don't leave because it's against the Bible or whatever. You might try to babble. See, all those shallow-minded people that love to debate stuff about, as an example, I just mentioned about divorce, that you should never get divorced, should always stay with your spouse. Those people are shallow end of the pool people because they don't know that people's lives could depend on what you say to people. And this is the kind of things that you deal with if you want to, and not just being a pastor, if you want to be an elder or a deacon or work for with our group, this Church of the Firstborn, we're going to have these elders in each area. So, that's what I need to, what I'm talking is really for those guys too. We're going to have these elders in each area who can baptize people, go and pray for people and all that, like Brother Sid in South Carolina, East Coast of South Carolina, Brother Brian down in the Houston area, in Western Houston area, and then the Long Ranger Sheriff there also in Houston, by the grace of God. Brother Garcia, the Lord will also have him as elder with the men's ministry there. We have to give people life and death information sometimes, and they're basing their decision for their life on what we say. As elders, all preachers and deacons and all that are elders for the Lord, and we have to give a special account to the Lord for what we say. Therefore, that's why I don't take any foolishness. I have no problem blocking people when they are talking wacky and talking nonsense. As an example, there's a guy who told me that if you don't, that he had a special revelation from God, you have to be baptized in the Holy Spirit to be saved. And if I didn't say that and agree with him that I was a false prophet, he's going to make a video against me and attack me and all that. I'm not a people pleaser, and I don't care what that dude thinks. I know what the Bible says, and anybody says they have a doctrine based on special revelation, hey, beep, 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 the cult alert goes off. That's where all these cults come from. Now, let me throw a disclaimer on here because there's always people who are on the shallow end of the pool who might not understand what I'm saying. I'm saying that if you are praying about moving to St. Louis and you feel the Lord gave you a special revelation or understanding, yes, you need to move to St. Louis, that's a non-biblical thing. Yes, God does lead us to change jobs, to move to this other place, blah, 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 to be a pastor, to be a deacon, to go to this church or go to that church, these kind of things. These are things that the Lord talks to us about. That's totally different than someone saying, oh, there's another gospel that I got from the Lord. As Paul said, if anyone, even us or an angel from heaven, gives you a different gospel than the one we already gave you, let them be accursed. It's from the book of Galatians. And so when someone says to you that you have to be baptized in the Holy Spirit and speak in tongues to be saved, that's another gospel. That's a different gospel than the one that's in the Bible. So therefore, that person is accursed based on what the Word of God says. So I would never give another gospel. By the grace of God, will I never give another gospel than what's written in the Word of God. So these are life and death situations. You start telling people stuff like that, you got to give a special account to the Lord for that. People could be lost because of your false doctrine. We have to give an account for that. So these are very serious matters, brothers and sisters. Very serious. So I ask for your prayers, for your encouragement. I ask you to, you know, lift me up, you know, even as her and her, the brother-in-law of Moses, and also the brother of Moses, Aaron. They held up his arms, you know, when he was on the mountain there at the battle that Joshua was winning the battle, as long as Moses had his arms lifted up. And so for me, you know, God is my banner, is what Moses said there at that mountain, Jehovah Nissi. And what I would say to you guys is that for me, my understanding for application for us is that we need to have our arms raised in prayer. As Paul said, I would have all men everywhere lifting holy hands to heaven, you know, and praising the Lord. So as we praise the Lord, we have the victory. And as we stop praising the Lord, you know, the enemy comes on in like a flood. And as we raise our arms and praise the Lord, then he lifts up a standard against the enemy's attacks. So I asked you guys to continue to pray for Joshua's ministry. Pray for me, please, that I will have the strength and the grace to keep my arms lifted up, to climb the mountain of God with my arms lifted up, always in prayer and praise and worship of the Lord. Because that has been the secret of my ministry for 13 years, is to praise and pray and worship the Lord, because the battle is the Lord's, not mine. And the problem with all these people that's on, you know, a lot of people on YouTube fussing and fighting and carrying on and all the things they're doing, they're fighting the battle themselves. All the people is debating and carrying on and clowning and debating and in their flesh on YouTube. That's the problem. People are in their flesh and they're fighting the battle themselves instead of letting the Lord fight the battle. But for me, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God, I always keep turning to let the Lord be the one to fight the battle, not me. And it comes through prayer and praise and worship, and through unity among the brethren, as King David said in Psalm 133, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It's like the oil that even ran down from Aaron, the high priest's beard, down to the hem of his garments. Let's have unity, brothers and sisters, unity in the bond of peace. And that's the word from the Lord in my heart. We are facing danger. The United States is facing severe, imminent wrath and judgment from the Lord. The whole world is, as we are on the precipice of the tribulation period, the great tribulation. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is kind of speaking something to me, and I don't know exactly what he wants me to say. Mark my words. Mark my words, the tribulation is at hand. And that's what the Lord wanted me to say. I didn't know exactly what he wanted me to say, how to say it. But mark my words, the tribulation is at hand. We need to be ready against the third day. We need to be ready to meet the Lord in the air. We need to offer our living sacrifice of praise unto the Lord. As it says, offer our bodies as a living sacrifice. I believe that's Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Be ready against the third day. Be ready to meet the Lord in the air. He loves you with an everlasting love, and he wishes none to perish, but all to come to repentance, to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, to the gospel of grace. By grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. God bless you guys. I appreciate your time. It's difficult, these things I'm sharing. That's why I haven't made a video this week. I've just been pondering all these things, meditating on it. You know, the Lord has got me in this place. I'm just totally by faith, and I don't, you know all the details, or none of the details. I've been in lots of places where I couldn't see what's over the next hilltop, but this is definitely probably one of the biggest, maybe. So, brothers and sisters, I thank you for your prayers. I know by faith the Lord's going to make a way. I just don't know how. And I just ask for your prayers to be strengthened through this season of the unknown. God bless you guys. I'm praying for you. You know that. There's hundreds of you that I've messaged with. And I continue to do it as long as the Lord would give me the strength and the wisdom and an internet connection and a computer to do it. And God bless you guys.